Hey guys, it's Claire. Welcome back. Today I wanted to do a quick Christmas book haul, and I realized that I don't actually do book hauls very often. I think I've only done two or three in the past, and that's because I really don't like filming them, because whenever I start talking about books I haven't read, I realize I have like nothing to say. But I think it's kind of a nice thing to do a book haul for a birthday or a holiday, because it's kind of an extra way to say thank you or express gratitude for books that you've gotten from people who care about you. So that's what I'm gonna do today, and I've got a nice pile here that I got over the holiday season, so let's get started. I'm gonna start with the two books that I've already had a chance to read since receiving them, and the first of those two books is Kitchen by Banana Yoshimoto. This is Banana Yoshimoto's most famous novel, although I would actually call it more of a novella, and I read it in one day in kind of that lull between Christmas and New Year's, and it was a really wonderful experience to just sit on the couch all day with it and read this wonderful story, which is about grief, but also in a weird way, kind of this really heartwarming love story as well. So I really loved it. And I have to give a shout out to Matthew Sharapa because he is the person who introduced me to Banana Yoshimoto. And this is the second book of hers that I've read so far. And I think I'm starting to understand her more and to appreciate her the more that I read her. And actually, this edition of Kitchen includes Banana Yoshimoto's short story Moonlight Shadow, which was one of my favorite fiction reads of 2017. The next book that I got for Christmas that I just finished last night is a true novel by Minae, Mizumura. This is a sort of Japanese retelling of Wuthering Heights, set largely in the years following World War II in Japan. I also got this book recommendation from Matthew Sharapa, and I really, really enjoyed it. There were definitely parts in the middle that dragged. That's kind of inevitable when you're reading a book that's over 800 pages, but I'm still kind of on this high from it, and I really enjoyed it and enjoyed the ending, so I'm excited to talk more about this in an upcoming wrap-up. Then I got three books from my older brother, which actually made me feel kind of bad because I only got him one book, but I mean, I'll take what I can get. The first of those books is South and West by Joan, Didion. This is a recently published collection of excerpts from the notebooks that Joan Didion kept while traveling around the South and West of America in the 1970s. And as you may or may not know, I'm a pretty big Joan Didion fan, and I think this will be a nice short and sweet read, and so I'm really excited to get to it. My brother also got me The Master and Margarita, which was a complete surprise, but I'm really happy to have this copy, which is a really wonderful 50th anniversary edition, and I really don't know anything about this book. I'm familiar with it, obviously, but he really loves it, and so I'm eager to get to this one too. The last book my brother got me is Upstream, which is a collection of essays by Mary Oliver, and actually, my parents also got me New and Selected Poems Volume 1 by Mary Oliver, and I have to give a shout out to Tortoise Dreams because in a comment on my Books About Nature video, they mentioned that I might really like Mary Oliver's poetry, so I'm eager to get to these, and I've actually started a little bit of the poetry, and I'm really digging it. And in the comments of that Books About Nature video, T with Darcy also mentioned that I might like the book Landmarks by Robert Macfarlane, which I asked my parents for Christmas, and they gave me this beautiful copy. Apparently it's about language and the landscape of the British Isles, which sounds right up my alley, so I'm really happy to have a copy of this as well. My parents also got me a copy of the collected stories of Lydia Davis, who I've been meaning to read for such a long time and have never read, so I'm really happy to have this copy of her stories, and also I'm really liking this tiny trim size too. I think it's really cute. It's a really pocket-sized book. They also got me A Room of One's Own by Virginia Woolf, which is another book I've been meaning to read forever. And then my little brother got me Race and Reunion, The Civil War in American Memory by David Blight. And I kind of fell down a Civil War rabbit hole last November, and then I found myself throughout the month of November listening to David Blight's Yale Open Courses lectures on the Civil War, which you can access online and also through the podcast app. I listened to all 27 lectures, you guys, and I had a great fucking time. So I'm really happy to have his book, which was also recommended to me by a professor when I was in college, but at the time I was like, I don't have time to read extra books, come on. But now I do, and so I'm really excited to dip into this at some point. And lastly, I have become really good bookish friends with Matthew Sharapa and Amy Poole in the past couple of months, and they were sweet enough to send me some books for Christmas, which was so nice and such a surprise and just wonderful. And so I want to say thank you to them for that. Matthew sent me Walk Through Walls, a memoir by Marina Abramovic, and I'm not super familiar with her, but I think this is a memoir about her life as an artist. And I also looked her up, and she grew up in post-war Yugoslavia, which is an area of the world that I'm super interested in, so I'm really excited to get to that book. And then Amy sent me Ex Libris, Confessions of a Common Reader by Anne Fadiman, and this is a book about books and language, which sounds great. And then she also sent me Where the Bluebird Sings to the Lemonade Springs, Living and Writing in the West by Wallace Stegner. And I had never heard of this book or of Wallace Stegner before she sent this to me, but I was flipping through it and it's a book about the American West and the landscape and writing, and it just sounds like all of the things that I love and am interested in, and it just makes me so happy to think that I have made these friends who know my reading taste like so well, and it's just so great. So needless to say, it was a really wonderful holiday season for me, a great end to 2017. I hope you all are having a wonderful start to your new year. If you got any books over the holiday season and have any particular favorites, let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.